Back-to-back wins this past week for Georgia State basketball over Troy and South Alabama. Panthers now getting set to go back on the road to the Carolinas as the season begins to wind down. Just a few weeks to go, and we'll be Thursday night at Appalachian State, Saturday afternoon at Coastal Carolina. It's Inside Georgia State Basketball this week. Dave Cohen joined on this week's show by one of the seniors, Jordan Tyson. You know, it was a great way to bounce back. You had the Alabama schools in here. And bouncing back from what was a tough trip to Louisiana, you know, took care of business against both Troy and South Alabama. Great way to build a little momentum now as you get ready to go back on the road.
Right, yeah, we definitely needed those wins. And now we're just trying to go on a streak so we can finish the season right and, you know, hopefully not top two, but number one in the conference, and just keep going from there and, you know, make the NCAA tournament again.
Coach Hunter says all the time that if you can win everything at home and split on the road, you'll put yourself in a pretty good position. Protecting the home court is of the utmost importance, and again, you guys did that this week against a Troy team that had beat us over there and against a South Alabama team that we had beat by just three down in Mobile.
Yeah, that was our goal for this weekend, to really bounce back, not only from the two losses that we had, but also, you know, we obviously lost against Troy, but we didn't feel like our South Alabama win was that great. So we just wanted to prove a point, especially with it being late February and, you know, going to March, we really want to hit a stride like we're doing right now.
Jordan, your role changed just a little bit. You've started now the last couple of games. You started against both Troy and against South Alabama. Against South Alabama, 6 points, two rebounds. Against Troy, 2 games ago, 4 points, couple of rebounds, throw in some blocks, throw in some steals. What's the difference for you from the mindset standpoint of coming in off the bench or like we've said the last 2 games, starting the ball game?
Well, the mindset hasn't changed. The mindset the whole time has just been doing my job and staying positive. So whether I was coming off the bench, whether I was, you know, playing 5 to 10 minutes a game or like 20 to 30, I'm always prepared to do my job and do it to the best of my ability.
You getting the start allows Coach Hunter to move Malik back out to the four, where I think he's more comfortable. We always kid around with Malik. He's the best three-point shooting five in the country. But that adds a little punch offensively with you coming into the ball game and adding what you add defensively, but yet allowing Malik to move out a little bit and focus a little bit more on offense.
Right, exactly. He always had a mismatch with the four and the five, but now that he's back at the four, he can take guys off the dribble. He can pick and pop and shoot. No one can really guard him in that position. And then me, not even necessarily scoring all the time, but yes, finishing around the rim when I need to, but rolling to the basket and creating opportunities and, you know, being a presence, creating opportunities for our shooters like Jeff D. Mitch and all those guys.
Well, as you know, you've been around here long enough. Coach Hunter always stressing defense. That's one of the reasons he told me on the radio pregame that he wanted to start you in these back-to-back ball games. Georgia State against Troy forced 19 turnovers, 10 steals. South Alabama forced 18 turnovers, 10 steals. That's the kind of defense that he's talking about.
Well, yeah, mine will probably be more credited to blocks. But, we definitely pick up the intensity when I'm out there. I just feel like I'm, you know, just a good inside presence for us to have. And, you know, the defense might get a little flustered trying to come inside, you know, with the length and, you know, the shot blocking ability. So not just to toot my horn the whole time, but, you know, just the intensity on defense picks up.
All right, lastly, again, another big challenge as we come down to crunch time. Right now, Georgia State currently behind Texas State in the standings in the Sun Belt Conference. So a lot on the line as you get ready to go to both Appalachian State and Coastal Carolina this week, which historically has been a tough road trip for us.
Yeah, but we definitely plan on coming out of there with 2 wins. So, they better watch out. It's going to be, yeah.
All right, appreciate it. Let's get off the mountain with a win. Let's get out of Myrtle Beach with a win and get back here.
Yeah, appreciate it.
All right, I want to thank Georgia State's Jordan Tyson. Georgia State again on the road Thursday night at Appalachian State. Saturday afternoon in Conway, South Carolina, take on Coastal Carolina. I'm Dave Cohen. That's this week's Inside Georgia State Basketball.